Hello friends, it's so cool that you are interested in Arduino lessons. The structure of the program in the Arduino IDE can be changed by the programmer depending on the tasks and specific solutions, but its main unchanged minimal skeleton, as in this example, necessarily consists of two setup and loop functions. Without them, the program will not compile. A function is a piece of program code that has a unique name and is delimited by the curly braces and can be accessed from elsewhere in the program. The direct purpose of function setup is for programmers to set the initial parameters of the controller functionality and program objects used in other parts of the program. The word loop means a repeating cycle, looping the execution of a set of expressions that are in this function. Its purpose is to store the expressions of the main loop of the controller program. To understand the differences between these functions, let's look at the block diagram of a minimal Arduino program. After the start, the controller is taken to process the expressions between the curly braces of the setup section. After completing the execution of all the tasks of the first function, the controller takes up the endless sequential execution of the program code of the loop section, which, according to the idea, should perform all the useful work laid down by us in dynamic mode. Now let's consider a simple example of a program with a similar structure, with the ability to monitor its execution in the port monitor, as well as by indication using a LED on the controller board. The Arduino Nano and Uno board has a LED connected to the 13th pin, and this program can blink with it. Here, a line of code has been added to the structure we have considered, which is located in front of and outside the curly braces of any function. In this place, it is customarily to place library connection strings, declarations of global variables, constants, and class instances. Next, we will complicate the structure in order to consider an example of connecting a library and declaring a class instance. This program writes "Hello World" on the LCD every second, but we will deal with indicators later. And now let's pay attention to the characteristic lines of code, which in the future we will often come across in various sketches. In the first place, there is a call to the liquid crystal library for working with symbolic liquid crystal indicators, and then the line for declaring an instance of one LCD indicator indicating the controller pins to which it is connected. You should also consider a typical example of a program structure with a user-defined function. Here we see the same skeleton of the program, but with the use of an additional function myfunc, which is called from the loop section. That is, the execution of the main program loop will be interrupted each time to execute this function. User-defined functions are convenient to use, but we will learn about this in later lessons. We will also often see comments in sketches, separated from the text of the program by oblique lines and asterisks. They are ignored by the program compiler, and do not participate in the operation of the program, but are used by programmers for various explanations to third-party readers and reminders for themselves. They can be single line or multi-line. We will also talk about them later. So we got an idea of the simplest building blocks that make up your future sketch programs for Arduino controllers. Remember that the contents of the setup function are processed by the controller once after the controller starts, and the contents of the loop function are processed cyclically without stopping. We also know that the sketch will not compile without these features. We also learned that in addition to these standard sections, the program can contain other user or library elements, which we will talk a lot about in the next lessons on the Arduino IDE.